I'm Swinny, and in this video we're going to see my part 1 for Raiden Shogun build here. So I have done D-Look part 1 build before, so this is the series we are I'm going to cover now. So with my characters which I'm using, so I'm going to cover them. So every single of my characters is off build as of now, so I haven't got the proper artifacts for them, so that's why it's kind of separated into part 1 and part 2. So part 2 will be out for each of the characters which I covering right now on my channel once I get the artifacts. So first up, let's check the attributes for our Raiden Shogun here. Let me point out this one here. So I was focusing for getting a Yae Miko. Instead I got a Raiden Shogun. So then I went for, so since I have kind of saved up a lot of artifacts for Yae Miko, I went up having a lot of good artifacts for Raiden Shogun here. So let's move on. So we do have HP 8,492 here, attack 1,198, it can be improved, defense 8,077, so limiter master 84, max stamina 240. So the thing I went for Raiden Shogun is this one here, that's the one, the energy recharge. So we do have a 285.8%. So she's at level 80, if I ascend her, I'll be getting like a 293.8% energy recharge. Base energy recharge will improve now. So with that increase, I can able to, so I can have like a 290 energy recharge. Hopefully I'll get around 300 my target. So one of my artifacts not having an energy recharge. So at level 90, she can have 300 energy recharge. It's at level 82, it's possible, but I'm not aware of it anyway. So let's see. See, she's having a elemental master 84. So as I was saying before, this is not best anyway. So you need a lot of elemental mastery for your characters like with the abilities you have. So with the overload, super conductivity and electro charge will do a lot of damage once elemental mastery is needed. So I don't have that much elemental mastery honor as of now. So my Lisa has elemental mastery, so that's for another video. So I'll showcase Lisa in separate limit. So critical rate is 57.5% here, critical damage is 114.5% here, energy recharge is 285.8%. The reason I'm kind of going after energy recharge is due to the fact she's an she's the best battery, so the energy battery in this game. So, and also the higher the energy recharge you have, she can deal a lot of damage with her energy burst. What do we have here? Side resistance 15%, electro damage bonus 120.9% here, and animal resistance 15%, cryo resistance 15%, geo resistance 15%, physical resistance 15%. So the thing I'm using now, the artifacts, let's go for weapons. So weapon is my as usual catch. The catch is not a big like a big surprise for everyone out here. So it's at a refinement rank 2. I haven't been fishing lately, so I'll hit like a rank 5 sooner. So increases elemental burst damage by 20% and elemental burst critical rate by 7.5%. So I need to improve this one. So I think it will be up by 35, around 35 mark, and 12% over here. I may be wrong, so we'll see it goes. It's been a while I've seen that stat anyway. So let's check on our concentration. So concentration 0. So I'll check the give the artifacts later. So talent is 5. So I need to improve this one so that I can regular viewer of mine showcase the charge attack for Raiden Shogun on her elemental burst is way better than the normal attacks for her on elemental burst. So if I improve this one here, what happens is the charge attack stamina cost will be reduced, and as well as the charge attack damage will be improved. So when compared to the 122, even fire damage can't be able to compare with the charge attack damage here. So it's better to go and upgrade this one if you have Raiden Shogun, and if you are using elemental burst just like me, like a lot of elemental burst for her. So go with the charge attack here. So I think it will improve. So I have seen it. It's kind of better to have a charge attack higher level here. So I'll try to do this one later. So that's why I'm said, as I was saying before, this is off build for it, off my characters here. So I don't think so. Zero constellation here. She's C0. So let's move on to the constellation here. It's not a big surprise here. I do have a one set piece bonus, emblem of severe fate as of now. So it's not fully filled. So as you are seeing here, say so, 2-piece energy set energy recharge plus 20%. I can able to switch it. Let me show it here. So I have I'll check the flower here. So the flower HP, critical damage, critical rate, energy recharge, attack. There you go. So that's a lot of bonus for her. So if I put like a probably I should replace the attack with the elemental mastery. That will improve more damage anyway. So that this is nearly perfect anyway. So I don't want to change this one anyway. So with every flower, as I was saying before, if you haven't checked my guide for choosing how to choose artifacts video, go and check that one. So it will be in at the end of this video. The link will be at the end of this video, or check it on my channel library. It will be there under Genshin Impact playlist. So that's our flower. So moving on to the plume. So we do have attack, attack, critical rate, and critical damage, elemental mastery. There you go. More attack. It's part of emblem of Severe Fate. So that's also good. So we do have critical rate and critical damage. So we don't have energy recharge. Hopefully I'll switch energy recharge over here. Yeah, energy recharge. This is the piece I think I'm missing, the energy recharge, or the other one too. So I think a couple of the pieces are kind of missing the energy recharge. So if I put energy recharge over here, like a critical rate, critical damage, elemental mastery, and energy recharge, that's the near perfect artifact. That's the perfect artifact for this for Raiden Shogun, at least for that's what I think anyway. So some people don't consider elemental mastery, but you need to consider elemental mastery so that if you do overload or super conductive or electro charge damage, it will with the elemental mastery it will do lot plenty of damage. So you can able to see it on the attributes here. So if you see it on the elemental mastery, so look at this one. So vaporize and melt is not needed. It's not available for her, but it's also overload, super conductive, electro charged, shattered, and spell is not considered here. So this thing will do 25.1% when compared to my Lisa here. I'll just showcase it for the time being. So look at this one here, 144.1% and 90.2% damage here as well. So elemental mastery improves here. So 673 elemental mastery over here. So elemental mastery will improve some damage. So it's nearly more than 25. So I'm kind of confused here. So 144, she needs elemental mastery. So Lisa needs elemental mastery. I'll cover it on a separate video. So elemental mastery, you need to overlook it anyway. So it will do a lot of damage. If you don't have set bonus, it's fine. So but elemental mastery is needed anyway. So that's what I'm saying. So let's check the plume. So the plume is done. So moving on to the sands here. So we do have energy recharge as the base stats and defense HP. So there you go. So we don't have energy recharge over here. The thing, I went for this one instead of this set piece here. So I don't have any proper set piece. Let me show here. So we do have energy recharge, attack, there you go, critical damage. So this one is very better than that one there. So that's why I haven't gone for this set piece, entire set piece. So if you have four piece set, increase the elemental burst damage by 25% of energy recharge, a maximum of 75% bonus attack can be obtained in this way. 75% damage is fine, but I need a critical rate and critical damage here. Probably I'll switch it sooner. So right now I'm using this one so that we'll have a critical rate, enough critical rate and critical damage. Yeah, you can able to see this one is way better than that one which I'm using now, but I need at least elemental mastery in one of the stat here. So energy charge and critical rate or critical damages will be fine. So there you go. So I don't have it. This one is a different stat. Yeah, that's useless. So that's how much sense I have for this set piece here. For now, I'll use this one, but I'll switch it later. So this, the four set piece set will do a lot of damage for with the Raiden Shogun. So for right now, I'm not using it. So we'll see. I don't have a proper one. So once I get this one, will be fine. But if it is three of the stats out of the three of the stats, I need elemental mastery. So if I went for the critical rate and the critical rate here, that's what I've done. Maybe I can replace this one. It's not a big deal, but it reduces our critical rate anyway. I'm not going to do that. So once I'm kind of hunting for this artifact, so I'll get it sooner. So as I was saying before, it's off build, so this one needs to be changed. Probably you guys find it, this one is on easily replaceable. So moving on to the goblet. So we do have electro damage bonus. So a critical damage here, energy recharge and elemental mastery. As I was saying before, energy recharge and elemental mastery. Having energy recharge and elemental mastery, I went for this one here. When compared to the goblet I have over here, so this one provides defense, right? So that's why I kind of gave it to Noel there. So I think it's double defense stats. Yeah, double defense stats. That's why I kind of gave it to Noel. We have this one, defense here, there you go. So physical damage bonus, we don't need that. Attack here, defense here, attack here. So I need electro damage bonus. So the one piece which I had which I have as of now provides electro damage bonus and the critical damage or with the energy charge is this one here. That's why I given it that one. So there you go. So no energy recharge here, enemy damage bonus here. A lot of things kind of falling into different places over there, all over the place. Anyway. So that's why I kind of gave this one. So the thing I'm going to replace either this one here or this one here. So if I get like any proper piece from the, what's it called? Emblem of Severe Fate in the next upcoming few days, like in the upcoming months, who knows when I'm going to get the one. So once I get it, I'll replace this one for the Emblem of Severe Fate set piece anyway. So those two needs to be replaced anyway. The final one is this one, the Onoto Kabuto, part of Emblem of Severe Fate set piece anyway. So we do have critical rate, critical damage. I do have energy recharge. That's why I chose this artifact. So even though I got to have defense and HP stats here, this one is fine. So probably I need to replace this one too. But for now, this one is fine. So there you go. So I don't have anything else better than that one over there. So critical damage here. I need critical rate and critical damage. So anything. Yeah, I think this one is fine. But I need energy recharge. So same before. You need energy recharge for Raiden Shogun. The thing with the energy recharge, let me show you why I'm kind of going for a ton of energy recharge is, if you check this one, this one here, each 1% above 100% energy recharge that the Raiden Shogun possesses grants her 0.6% greater energy restoration from Musho Ishin, and also 0.4% electro damage bonus. That's a lot of bonus anyways. And also if you consider going for this four set piece bonus over here, increase elemental burst damage by 25% of energy recharge. So if I switch one of these pieces for the other one, I'll deal more damage for now. So I'm doing 30 to 40k damage as critical. So it can be increased anyway. So as I was saying before, it's off build. So that's the end of this one here. If you have any questions regarding this one, I'll post I'll reply to you anyway. Post it in the comments below. So I'll reply you guys in the comment section anyway. And I check my community tab at time to time. So I'll be posting a lot of things over there. So community tab is my social interaction with you guys anyway. So we do have I covered Diluc, and this one is the second one. Probably I'll cover the next one later. So I'm not sure which character going to be. I'll be covering this one. So as I was saying before, all my characters is all built. So we'll see it goes. So that's the end of this one here. Take care, everyone. Hopefully you find this guys. You'll find this video useful anyway. So thanks for watching anyways. Bye for now. Take care, everyone.